Hi guys, it's Elitesquadx here and welcome to your final Adobe Premiere Pro tutorial. Now we're coming to the end of the tutorials guys, there's not really much else I can show you. So the last thing on the list is obviously exporting. Now exporting really depends on who you are. You know, if you prefer videos that are in HD, all my videos are in HD, 1080p HD, that's why I put a little HD in brackets on my videos. If you didn't know that guys, you can watch my videos in HD, but also, you know, you may be a person who is that needs like smaller file sizes, you know, someone who hasn't got maybe the best internet but has got some good footage, you really want to make a video and you just really want to upload it and you want something that's small and really quick to upload. So I'm going to be taking you through that. So to export, you go File, Export, conveniently, and then it says Media. Now I'm not highlighted on timeline here, so File, Export, Media, or Control M if you're using the keyboard shortcuts. Now straight away here you've got your little render bar here, you can just scan through, make sure everything's 100% as you wanted it. So now at the top right it says export setting, export settings. Now the format, like I said, it depends on who you are. For me it is H.264. Now this is your default HD exporting settings. So once you clicked on whatever you want, I mean if you're not doing HD I recommend perhaps AVI, or perhaps you've got another save that you usually use and you know what you're doing, but AVI is the only thing I could recommend apart from HD, but I usually use HD so I wouldn't know. So H.264 is the format. And then when we go into the presets, we've got a whole bunch of presets you want. Now the preset I usually use is the HD 1080p 29.97 high quality. Now of course this is the highest of the highest, so yes, the for a 7 second video the estimated file size is 28 meg, but you know, I do like my videos to be the highest of quality for you guys to enjoy. But other presets, you got the YouTube widescreen, I mean, and YouTube standard definition. I mean, look, if you click on the widescreen, you can see the file size only goes down to 5 megs. So, you know, if you people want to have a decent HD video and you want a small file size, and you know, that's kind of the settings for you if you want to go on YouTube. But I usually use the HD 1080p. So, once you got that, you just change the output name by clicking on it, saving it where you want. That's quite simple. So then you've got the summary, don't really need to look at that, it just tells you how the video is going to be saved. So now at the bottom here there's all these little tabs, so if you're not happy with your preset, basically you can click on these tabs and you can change the width, the frame rate, the aspect ratio, all these little details that about your exploitation. Now if you don't want to play around with these, that's fine, you don't really have to because your preset should do it for you, but if you do want to go, you know, experiment with some exploitation, I mean that you can change the frames per second there, you've got the standard definition with the PAL or NTSC. I keep my level on 4.2, it's quite high, it's good, good exploitation, 16:9 of course, and yeah, you just got all these different settings. Audio is for format, it's usually AAC, that's the highest quality for HD video. And then you've got the multiplex here of the MP4, which is the usual. Now there is a setting here which is called maximum render quality, as it says here, gives better quality scaling but increases the encode time. Now for this I would only recommend using it when you have short videos. Reason for this is because if you have long videos that are about, I don't know, roughly 10 minutes long, exportation time usually for HD for me is around about 15 minutes for 10 minute videos, but with maximum render quality you're looking at least an hour, so it is quite a high rendering, it is really high, it does take a long time, so if you haven't got the powerfulest PCs I wouldn't recommend it at all. But the only time I use it is for my intro. If you've seen my introduction, it's I like it now as my intro. If you've seen that, that was used using the maximum render quality. Reason for this is because as you see here it is 7 seconds long, so even using the maximum render quality you're still only looking at, I don't know, about 5 minutes. I mean, yeah, for a 7 second video, that is quite a long time, but you know, it is to get the best quality out of your videos. So that's kind of all the, you know, all the exploitation settings. You don't really need to play around with most of them, it's just the format and the preset really depends on you. Thanks for watching guys, this has been the last episode of my Adobe Premiere Pro tutorials. Now, if you guys have liked what you've seen here, please be sure to thumbs up, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And if you guys have any problems with Adobe Premiere Pro, please be sure to message me, and I can help you out with that. And please be sure to check out my Minecraft Let's Do This series, because you know that's what I'm going to be continuing with from now onwards for a little while perhaps. Maybe I'll do something different. But apart from that, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you later.